Hi everybody, Justin Horniger from the Running Through Podcast YouTube page here, and today I want to talk to you about Jerrion Lawson's successful CAS appeal. If you aren't familiar with Jerrion Lawson's story, Jerrion Lawson is a U.S. Olympian who was initially suspended for 4 years for epitrenbolone, that's how you say it, which is an anabolic steroid frequently used in livestock. This will come up in a second, but initially found positive in both his A and his B samples. This triggered a 4-year doping ban. There are some problems with this. So Lawson was suspended. He appealed it to the Court of Arbitration of Sport, and the appeal was successful, and the ban was lifted. That came out earlier last month. Today, CAS and the Doping Integrity Unit really released all the documents involved, so all the arguments, everything that kind of went into that CAS case, and I wanted to go through them and just analyze them a bit because it really highlights some issues with our current doping system. It's good that Lawson got off because I feel like he is not guilty in this case. However, if he was guilty, I think he still would have, because there are some issues with how IAAF at the time and WADA at the time handled this case. So let's talk about understanding Jerrion Lawson's successful CAS appeal. When he was initially suspended for 4 years, it was seen as just another doping case with an athlete accused claiming his innocence. However, Lawson would prove to be vindicated last month, and it's eerily similar to the Aji Wilson case, if you're familiar with how Aji Wilson got off for contaminating meat cause. There are two big points here though. Jerrion Lawson's epitrenbolone levels were too low to produce any sort of performance benefit. So the big thing here is that it seemed to be a one-time thing, which really suits kind of the theory that Lawson came up with. So here's some quotes from the actual case file. The appellant underwent a hair sample test by Dr. Pascal Kintz, one of the world's leading toxicologists, as soon as he was notified of the positive test. Dr. Kintz found that the athlete's hair was clean and produced no positive results for trenbolone. Dr. Kintz added that there is no reason for an athlete to use trenbolone on a single occasion. So this kind of proves that it wasn't a buildup, it wasn't a prolonged use. Trenbolone for one-time use, any anabolic steroid for one-time use really, if it's a big enough dose, first off, if it's a big enough dose, it's going to be found in a hair sample. If it's a prolonged usage, it's going to be found in a hair sample. This kind of reiterates that this was probably a contamination issue. Now, it helps Lawson's case that he immediately acted and sought out a hair sample test. He sought out a lie detector test. He tried to find where the source of contaminated meat came from, and he found it. He came with receipts. He came with bank statements. However, because something we'll talk about next, he wasn't able to actually find the contaminated meat. Now, the test proved that Lawson was not on epitrenbolone for an extended period of time. I'm going to mispronounce that 12,000 times this video. For an extended period of time, and could not receive any performance benefit from the level found in his system. This is similar to the argument used by Aji Wilson in her contaminated meat case, which I'll post down below in the video notes. If you want to learn more about what's going on here, I'll post some things down there that will be interesting if you're into this kind of stuff like I am. And it's shown to be an effective hill to plant your case on, especially since contaminated meat in USA's food supply seemed to be commonplace, and they pointed out in this appeal that contaminated meat supply in the US is similar to kind of Mexico's level at this point, so it's getting worse. This is a lesson to everyone in the testing pool that you need to know what you're putting into your body and where it comes from, because this really helped Lawson out. If he wasn't as diligent, he wouldn't have been able to track down the source, which would have hurt his case, I think, in a pretty big way. However, I don't think it would have hurt it all the way, because IAAF and the World Anti-Doping Council seem to have mishandled Lawson's case pretty severely. One of the quotes, "The appellant's burden to prove meat contamination was made more difficult by the respondent's inexcusable failure to report his positive test results for almost 2 months after the test. This was a breach of the respondent's duty pursuant to Article 7.3 of the World Anti-Doping Council, which requires anti-doping organizations to promptly notify athletes of positive test results. During this 2-month delay, the opportunity to secure vital evidence was lost." And this is big for two reasons. IAAF taking 2 months, it's simply unacceptable, right? This is not cool. This should not be the case in any way. In the time it took Lawson to be notified, he could have obtained meat samples. or other relevant information that would have drastically helped his case. The flip side of it, if Lawson was guilty, if he actually was doping, in those 2 months, Lawson competed in 3 separate Diamond League events and a World Championships event. It's not good. And frankly, it ruins the integrity of the sport if that's the case, because oftentimes prize money won during that period, it's iffy if the people in the competition are going to recoup that or not. If you finished fourth and Lawson won or finished top 3 and you'd be moved up from the podium, a lot of times you aren't getting that extra compensation that you would have gotten otherwise. So it's a big issue. And I don't believe it was anything really nefarious from the authorities involved, but it just highlights how far from perfect our anti-doping system is right now. So that's kind of in full Jerry and Lawson's case. If you want to read more about it, I'll post it down below in the video description. As always, if you like this video, give me a little thumbs up action. If you want to see more of what I have, subscribe to me, because I got a lot coming this week, because I'm bored, I'm in my apartment, and I got nothing else to do. I even started a TikTok yesterday. That's how just looking for things to do I am. Anyway, hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day. Happy running.